Bateman, and today I will be discussing the affirmative side of Article 17, the crisis in the education of boys. Keeping boys and girls in mind, the crisis begins with stereotyping. Stereotyping is an issue that begins in the home and continues in the commercial realm. For example, blue is for boys and pink is for girls. But the stereotyping does not stop there. It continues in schools and in the academic and career path of students. The stereotyping carries on with teachers being gender biased. They have different gender expectations, and the teachers also interact differently with male and female students. Some examples of the gender stereotypes in schools are that girls are ahead of boys in reading and writing, and males being more privileged and less committed to school, and males are less likely to go to college. Michael Gurian, who is a brain researcher, talks about the crisis of boys in the article Learning and Gender. He also discusses it in his 2006 Newsweek article titled The Boys Crisis. He states that in every level of schooling, boys are falling behind. Dr. Gurian is so determined to help the boys in crisis that the Gurian Institute has enrolled 15,000 educators in its seminars on brain-based strategies to help the underperforming boys. The difference in boys' and girls' minds is reflected in the learning of gender-specific ways. Thanks to today's technologies, such as MRIs and positron emission tomography, also known as PET scans, which is similar to MRIs. These scans allow us to look inside the brains of boys and girls. After looking at the brains, it is evident that there are many structural and functional differences. These differences affect how humans may learn. Since the brain is set up differently, boys and girls will learn in gender-specific ways. Girls' minds are set up very differently than boys, and they have many different brain characteristics. One of the largest characteristics are that girls' minds have a larger corpus callosum. A corpus callosum is the connecting bundle of tissues between the hemispheres of the brain. The brain has two separate hemispheres, a right and a left side of the brain. The corpus callosum allows the right and the left side of the brain to communicate. A girl's corpus callosum is 25% larger than a boy's corpus callosum. A second characteristic is that the hippocampus is also larger in a female's brain. The hippocampus is a part of the brain that is used for memory storage. This characteristic allows females to have a higher retaining of information. The differences in learning is shown in the differences between the two genders' brains. Learning with a male brain becomes difficult because of some of the characteristics that it possesses. For example, a boy's mind has less brain space that is used for verbal functioning. Boys tend to use most of their brain for spatial mechanical functions. These functions include math and science, and doing things with their hands and figuring out how things work. Boys' brains are also programmed to reset itself in a state known as the rest state. An example of the rest state is demonstrated in Noll's book, Taking Sides, when Dr. Gurian talks about how a boy in the back of the classroom who has become bored with the lesson drifts off into a daydream or possibly falls asleep. Dr. Gurian calls this zoning out. At this time, the boy has not retained any of the information that he has heard. A girl, on the other hand, that has grown bored of a lesson can still keep her eyes open and pay attention and retain the information she has just learned, although she is not fully paying attention. The Gurion Institute came up with the idea of a nature-based approach in 1996. The nature-based approach is the importance of basing education on the information that we have about the differences in the brains of males and females. The students of the Gurion Institute argue that the education system today is set up for both boys and girls to fail. After looking at the MRIs and the PET scans, it is incredible to see the difference in the brains of male and female. Not only was it apparent that there were huge differences, but the boys and girls were trying to learn the same lesson with different brain methods. It then became obvious that if the teachers were trained in gender-specific ways, then the boys and girls could learn to their fullest potential. Teacher training is a very important step in the nature-based approach. The University of Missouri has been launching a program that involves gender training. The program has shown great results in the 6 school districts that it has demonstrated in. For example, Edison Elementary test scores fell at the bottom of the 18 surrounding district elementary schools. But after being involved in the gender training for teachers, they have tested in the top 5 slots. There have been times when they have been first or second. The school has improved so much that there are only 2 students in the whole school that require state-mandated retesting. But not only has the test scores increased, the number of disciplinary referrals have decreased. But Missouri is not the only place that does this type of training. Alabama also does teacher training on brain differences and different methods of teaching. But they have also have a middle school that separates the boys and girls. Since the separation of boys and girls, girls' math and science scores have improved, and so have boys' reading skills. The training of teachers on gender-specific learning has proven itself to be a beneficial thing for the education of boys. After the teachers complete their training, they go on to create a nature-based classroom. A nature-based classroom is a classroom that is set up for the specific learning of the specific sex. For example, in order to meet boys' needs, the classroom would be set up with lots of learning space. The tables and chairs would have more space between them than in a normal classroom. Also, the materials on the table would be spread out more because boys need more physical learning space. The activities in the room would be things such as building blocks, and instead of having the boys tell you how they feel about them, a teacher should ask them to explain what they are building. Boys usually find it easier to explain what they are doing rather than how they are feeling.